Hi, this is the second part on my video on Q&As. So let's see which questions do I answer now. Shall we? Hi, this is the second video on my Q&As. So let's start. Question number one, do I have to adjust the duty cycle? Well, both yes and no. That is the answer. Because if you are the second or the third owner and the owners before you were your father or your grandfather, and you know for sure that the CEO screw has never, and I repeat, never been touched, then no, you don't have to adjust the duty cycle, never. But if you are the owner of the car and you don't know anything about the history of the car, then it would be recommendable to check the duty cycle and eventually to adjust it. Question number two. I want to do duty cycle. Why I don't get any fluctuation? Now, in order to get the fluctuation, you have to know that your lambda probe must be fully operational. That's the precondition number one, and the precondition number two is that your car must be at 80. If your car is not at the operating temperature, then you won't get any fluctuation. Then you should get a steady number of 50%. Otherwise, you won't get the needed fluctuation. If your car is warm, then and you don't get the fluctuation, then either your lambda is bad or the wiring harness is bad. Something there is not good. The question number three. What is actually the duty cycle on KE? Now, I don't want to bother you with that story about the stoichiometric ratio, the ideal air to fuel ratio, blah, blah, blah. I want to show you in practice what it means. The duty cycle is the ideal balance on a lever. On that lever, you have the airflow sensor on one part that goes in, or let's see how much. For this much. And on the other side, you have the plunger inside the fuel distributor that goes in for this much here. See for yourselves. Now, you have to bring these two in an ideal balance. That's your duty cycle. Well, look now. In order to achieve this, the engineers in Bosch have figured out that it's impossible to do with one lever only. So they mounted one more lever. Here, you have like here you have the bar, and here is the first, the main lever that moves the air flow meter, the sensor plate, and this second one, that one determines the free play, because they figured out also that they need a little free play before the plunger in the fuel distributor starts moving upwards. So the more you take your Allen screw and you put it, and the more you turn it clockwise, the more you raise this lever, and earlier this lever is going to touch the plunger inside the distributor, and vice versa. And these engineers came to the conclusion how to teach the mechanics in the dealerships how to achieve this ideal balance between the two things, let's say it as such things, and they labeled this thing as percents, as 50% plus minus 5%. The next question: can I do the duty cycle without measuring percents? The answer is yes, you can. And you do the same procedure as if you wanted to do that with percents, but now you're going to be measuring voltage. Just set your multimeter to DC volts, and you want to have the fluctuation between 6 and 7.2 volts. This is just the introduction to my next video I'm going to be talking about, and that's going to be the duty cycle. The next question: what's the only thing I need to replace on the airflow meter? The only thing you have to replace on the airflow meter is this thing, the potentiometer, and nothing else. Eventually, you will have to replace the rubber boot if it is cracked, and you get vacuum leaks, then that's everything you have to do on the airflow meter. The next question: is my car going to run better if I adjust the duty cycle? The answer is no. Absolutely not. You can adjust your duty cycle to be perfect, but if your fuel pump is bad, if your fuel pressure regulator is bad, if your injectors, if these are bad, then no duty cycle is going to help your engine run better. Here I would conclude this series of the Q&As. So my dear ones, if you enjoyed this video, then please don't click the button skip ad. It is going to help me a lot. And till the next video, happy Mercedesing. Bye.